out of all the years that I've kept the bees, I've only had 2 years, I think, I've had pure ling heather honey. It never granulates.
So we're in the rural Aberdeenshire, quite near Benahee. It's August of 2020. We're well out of Aberdeen and it's a lovely day to come up into the hills.
We're on a heather moorland near Dinnet, which is world renowned for being one of the best places to get heather honey.
Most Scottish beekeepers will move their bees to the heather moors at this time of year. I guess originally they would bring them on a cart, now we bring them in a car.
During the winter months I help run the classroom sessions, and then during the summer months I help with the mentoring. This year obviously has been slightly different because of COVID, so there hasn't really been the mentoring. We've just done what we can, but it's been very, you know, distanced. So it's been a different year, not ideal at all.
People in the south of England maybe envy us for having lots of heather. We envy them for having better weather.
It's funny, we dread an east wind, you know. My father said, when the wind was in the east, we'll get 3 days at least.
We've got a Bulgarian member of our association, and he was saying to me the other day, he said, you look in the mirror tomorrow morning when you wake up, Dave, and just say, you are a hero. He said, anybody who keeps bees in Scotland is a hero. They've got to be a hero because it's so difficult.
And I always say to beginners, if you keep your bees as close to the way as nature intended, you will be a beekeeper, you know.